Hi guys, I wanted to show you this quite unusual camera I got from eBay. It is an Olympus E300. It was a model released in 2005. It was probably extremely expensive back in the time because it is still worth around 200 euros in working condition. So there is something very special about this camera. It is not the chunky and bulky design. It is not the weird pop-out flash. Other side is pretty usual. You have the optical viewfinder, LCD, selection wheels on the top. Of course, proprietary, where is it? Power plug here. So this one came with the battery, which is a good thing. I have not the charger, but the battery is charged, and anyway it will not be used because the issue is the shutter, which is not working with this camera. So there is one very special thing. So this part here is in a different material than the others, but it seems to be die-cast aluminium, magnesium or something like this. Now the very special feature is in this mirror box. So I will zoom in for you. So I hope it is in focus. So the very special thing with this camera is that the mirror flips on a vertical axis. It flips like this to the right, to the left side of the mirror box, and not vertically. So of course the focusing screen glass is on this side, so you can just imagine the complicated optical path we have with a focusing screen here and the optical viewfinder here. It means we must have a whole bunch of mirrors driving the light to the optical viewfinder. So there is something else, in fact. The as usual, the autofocus sensor is located at the bottom, but you cannot have usually you have a small mirror in behind the main mirror which flips out of the way when you take the photo, but here it is located here at the back, and it is a moving part which goes on the bottom like so when you shoot a photo. So I will demonstrate it. So the issue is the shutter which will not open. But if I trigger it, you can see everything goes out of the way, and at this time the shutter should be opened. Obviously it is not working, so either it is stuck or there is a problem in the electronic control of the shutter. But it is quite amazing. In fact, it is not easy to tell. It looks like, yes, only one curtain of a shutter is stuck. In fact, yes, the other part is working correctly. As you can see, we have a white background here, which is the second curtain. So half of the shutter is not working, not completely the complete shutter assembly. It is quite interesting. We have here the little display. It is complaining about the low battery currently and about the lack of memory card. So quite a neat little display, but neat menus it seems, and probably a very very fine camera making very beautiful pictures with if you can afford the lens to put on it. But sadly this one is purely for the collection. I would like to be able to find one in a bad condition for doing a teardown of it, but as it is extremely rare, I will keep this one in my collection. There is a little damage here on the top. I did put some black paint because it was bare metal. Apart from this, yes, very unusual setup in this mirror box. It is the first time I see it, and I think it is probably the only camera with this weird design. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.